Hi everyone, I'm Dr. Anisha and I welcome you to my channel. In the previous videos, we were discussing about the odontogenic tumors of the oral cavity. But today, we shall be discussing a new topic, a new chapter of oral pathology, that is epithelial tumors of oral cavity. Now, this chapter shall be completed in different kinds of categories. Firstly, I'll be covering the benign tumors of the oral cavity. Then we'll move on to the pre-malignant lesions of the oral cavity. And finally, we shall be covering the malignant tumors of the oral cavity of epithelial origin. But before starting the discussion, I would like you to kindly subscribe my channel for further videos. Now, as we are starting this topic, I would like to go through the terms tumor and neoplasia once again. So, tumor is simply the growth of any tissue which leads to the swelling of that area. Alright, so tumor by definition is simply a swelling of the tissue in a strict sense. Whereas when I talk about neoplasia, agar main neoplasia ki baat karun, to neoplasia by definition is an abnormal mass of tissue. Kisi bhi tissue ka overgrowth basically in an uncontrolled manner, uncoordinated manner with that of the normal tissue. Agar hum normal tissue ke comparison mein neoplastic tissue ko observe karenge, to jo neoplastic tissue hoga, that will be very uncoordinated. Dono ka jo multiplication rate hoga, growth ka rate hoga, that is very much uncoordinated. Also, the second most important thing about neoplasia is, even after cessation of the stimuli, agar aap us stimuli ko agar aap stop kar denge, body agar us stimuli ko, cessation ho jayegi us stimuli ki, tabhi bhi ye jo aapka growth hai, ye jo aapka multiplication hai un cells ka, that will not be stopped. So, this is the basic difference between a tumor and a neoplastic tissue. Now, if I talk about this particular topic, so I have already told you that epithelial tumors of the oral cavity shall be completed in three different categories. Firstly, we will be covering the benign tumors of the oral cavity. And if I talk about benign tumors of oral cavity, to hum is category mein do most important lesions ko, conditions ko hum study karenge. Firstly, we are gonna cover squamous papilloma. Secondly, we will be covering keratoacanthoma. So, one by one, I shall be, touching the topics. So, let us move on to the first topic, that is your squamous papilloma. So, if I talk about the introduction of squamous papilloma, firstly, let us split the word. The word is squamous. That means somewhat it is related to the, squamous cells of the oral cavity. Now, the second term is papilloma, and literally the word papilloma means finger-like projections. So, something related to squamous cells and have finger-like projections is ultimately the, appearance of squamous papilloma. So, if I talk about introduction, jo squamous papilloma hai, that is associated with the papilloma virus. Now, something which is to be kept in mind is, jo aapka human papilloma virus 6 and 11 hai, that is the main, virus which is related to squamous papilloma. It is the fourth most common mucosal lesions of the oral cavity. And although HPV lesions are, infective in nature, jo bhi aapke lesions honge, jo human papilloma virus se associated honge, they are mainly infective in nature. But then, this squamous papilloma caused by HPV 6 and 11 are, somewhat, they have less virulence and infectivity rate. So, this was all about the introduction of squamous papilloma. Let us discuss the clinical features of squamous papilloma. I already told you it has got a finger-like projection. So, basically it has an exophytic kind of growth. And jiske wajah se it gives a varicose or cauliflower-like appearance which is rough in nature. Now, agar main location ki baat karun, to most commonly it has been observed that they are found at, tongue portion. And apart from tongue, it can also be present on lips, buccal mucosa, now your gingiva, एंड ऑल्सो एडजेसेंट टू द यूवुला. अगर मैं क्लिनिकल प्रेजेंटेशन की बात करूं, सो बेसिकली इट इज वेल सर्कमस्क्राइब्ड लीजन एंड पेडिंकुलेटेड इन नेचर एंड ओकेजनली सेसाइल. ऑल राइट, नाउ क्लिनिकल प्रेजेंटेशन में इट इज पेनलेस एंड एज फार एज कलर इज कंसर्न इट इज वाइट टू पिंकिश इन कलर डिपेंडिंग अपॉन द यू नो कॉन्टेंट ऑफ द केराटिन प्रेजेंट ओवर द पैपिलोमा. Now the next point is about the size, which ranges from few millimeters to centimeters. So we have one more lesion known as common wart or verruca vulgaris, and it is very much similar to your squamous papilloma in terms of appearance. So let us see few points about common wart. So it is the most common tumor of warty tumor of the skin. And it is analogous to your oral or squamous papilloma. Now, as I told you, it is very much uncommon on your oral mucosa, but it is very commonly found on the skin. Now, when I talk about the associated HPV, so we had HPV 6 and 11 associated with your squamous papilloma, but here in verruca vulgaris, the associated HPV or human papilloma viruses are strain number 2, 4 and 40. I'll repeat it again, strain number 2, 4 and 40 are the strains of HPV which are, you know, associated with your verruca vulgaris. Now, as far as the clinical presentation is concerned, verruca vulgaris has pointed or verrucous projection with a very narrow stalk, okay. Now, it is gonna appear white due to the deposition of the keratin, alright, and they are present as multiple or clustered individual lesions. So, this was the clinical presentation about, related to the verruca vulgaris. Now, as far as size is concerned, the squamous papilloma was, you know, ranging from few millimeters to centimeters, but here the verruca vulgaris or the common wart, they have size more than 5 millimeters. All right. Also, the most important point to be kept in mind is your squamous papilloma was not contagious. They had a very low virulence or infectivity rate. But then, in contrast to squamous papilloma, jo aapka verruca vulgaris hoga or common wart hoga, which is, associated with the skin, they will be very much contagious. And in fact, the contamination is by auto inoculation. All right. The infected person's skin or membrane, is capable of spreading to some other part of the body. So this was all about the clinical features of squamous papilloma. Also, we, compared one more warty lesion called verruca vulgaris with that of your squamous papilloma. Now moving on to the histological features of squamous papilloma. Agar histology ki baat ki jaye, toh it is very specific and it has a characteristic microscopic papillary kind of appearance. Now it consists of long, thin, finger-like projections which extend from the mucosa. तो जो आपका ओरल म्यूकोजा होगा माइक्रोस्कोपिकली भी ये जो स्क्वामस पैपिलोमा है ये लॉन्ग थिंग फिंगर लाइक प्रोजेक्शंस जैसा अपीयर होगा. अगर मैं सेल्स की बात करूं तो ईच फिंगर लाइक प्रोजेक्शन इज मेड अप ऑफ स्ट्रेटिफाइड स्क्वामस एपिथीलियम एज आई ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू एंड ऑल्सो द नेम सजेस्ट्स. And the most important thing is, they surround a central core of connective tissue, which also has blood vessels and it supplies to the nutrient blood vessel. Now, the next point says some papillomas, show hyperkeratosis. As I already told you, few papillomas show whitish appearance. So this whitish appearance is basically present due to the hyperkeratosis. And studies have reported that this hyperkeratosis, which is seen occasionally, is basically a secondary reaction to the trauma or friction which is subjected to the papilloma. Now the next point says the proliferation of the spinous cell of the squamous papilloma is basically in the pattern of finger-like projections and so the appearance. Now, occasionally papillomas demonstrate basilar hyperplasia and also mild epithelial dysplasia. And so, because of this basilar hyperplasia and mild epithelial dysplasia, squamous papillomas occasionally can be a matter of concern. All right. Now, coming to the next point, which is very important from the examination point of view. So, we have a term known as coallocytes. So, coallocytes are the HPV altered epithelial cells. And the most important thing about these cells are they have perinuclear clear spaces and also the nuclear pycnosis is seen. So, coallocytes may or may not be found in superficial layers of your epithelium. Now, when I talk about chronic inflammatory cells, so the presence of chronic inflammatory cells may also be noted within the connective tissue. So, this was all about the histological features of your squamous papilloma, which overall has stratified squamous epithelium, like multiplicated in a finger-like projection along with a central core of connective tissue, which has different amount of blood vessels, your chronic inflammatory cells and so on. Coming to the treatment and prognosis of squamous papilloma and also of verruca vulgaris. So, if I talk about the treatment of squamous papilloma, it can be treated by simple surgical excision and the inclusion of stalk along with the base of the mucosa is to be done. Now, if I talk about the recurrence rate of squamous papilloma, so definitely it is going to be low if the excision is done properly, the stalk or the pedicle and the base of the mucosa, if removed properly, if excised properly, the recurrence rate will definitely be low in case of squamous papilloma. Now, if I talk about the treatment plan of verruca vulgaris, since it is a contagious disease, so a proper conservative surgical excision is to be done along with a proper curettage of the area so as to avoid auto-inoculation. And the other treatment options which are available, which have been reported in case of verruca vulgaris, is your usage of liquid nitrogen therapy. Also, some keratinolytic agents like salicylic acid can also be used for the treatment of verruca vulgaris. So, this was all about the benign tumor of oral cavity, one of the benign tumors of oral cavity, that is your squamous papilloma. Also, we discussed few points regarding verruca vulgaris or common wart also. And in the next discussion, we shall be touching one of the most important benign tumors of oral cavity, which is epithelial in origin, that is your keratoacanthoma. And it shall be, very important from the examination point of view also. And if you have any doubts regarding this topic, you can get back to me in the comment section. Also, if you like the video, do like, share and subscribe.